All right, Final Battle 2011. Star ratings are in the description. I don't plan on watching the show again, so I really don't care what anyone says. I'm just giving you the star ratings. It was okay. I wouldn't say this is great. A lot of stuff, a lot of the booking was kind of questionable on this show. Kevin Steen was the MVP. He was pretty much, really kind of, I wouldn't say is saving Ring of Honor right now, but really, it's a breath of fresh air just to see him back on the roster. And his he just did a lot of great stuff in the show. So yeah, just a it was a mixed bag tonight. Hero coming back was cool and everything, but even that had its flaws. A lot of the matches went way too long. It just a really tough show to sit through, I would say. Just a lot of mixed emotions. A lot of the guys felt really stale on the show. The main event seemed very flat, I would say, at some points. But overall, it was still good. The first match on the show, you had T.J. Perkins versus Michael Elgin. I'm gonna give it 3.5. I thought it was really solid. Obviously, you have a great combination of power versus speed. T.J. looked really awesome here, and Michael Elgin. There's really little you can complain about with this guy. This guy brings it in the ring, and I thought T.J. and Michael Elgin had one of the best matches on the show. Definitely one of the hottest, one of the brightest spots in the show was this match. Just great stuff. I really loved it. Elgin did so much innovative offense in this match. With countering T.J.'s high flying maneuvers and. I really enjoyed it. Just a great way to start off the show. All right, after that, yeah, Jimmy Rave versus Tommaso Ciampa. The interesting thing about this is, Jimmy Rave looks pretty good since he's come back. He's obviously not on the drugs anymore. He's cleaning himself up, which is always an intriguing story once you hear about that. And then, what's his name? Prince Nana. Jimmy Rave and Prince Nana have a huge history. Jimmy Rave is the former crown jewel of the embassy, and they're finally Jimmy Rave ended up losing the match. It was average. Tommaso Ciampa looked decent, I would say, not great, but okay. Jimmy Rave really didn't get to show what he could do. He actually hit the Rave Clash, and everyone was chanting AJ Styles because AJ Styles and Jimmy Rave had a feud in Ring of Honor in the past, where Jimmy Rave was banned from using the Styles Clash. So that was a pretty cool thing to see. But other than that, it kind of plants the seeds for a Jimmy Rave versus the Embassy feud, which I think longtime Ring of Honor fans would be interested in. But we'll see what happens. I'm not sure. This might be a one and done type of thing for Jimmy Rave. We'll just have to see. Right after that, you had El Generico, the Prodigy Mike Bennett, and Jay Lethal for Jay Lethal's Television Championship in a three-way dance. The Prodigy Mike Bennett came out with Maria. Maria was looking great. She looked like a porn star, slash, stripper. She was very exposed. She looked hot though. It was really tough not to think about her during the match. She really was looking pretty stunning, I would say. She's kind of it's kind of quizzical as to why she's with a guy like Mike Bennett. I just don't know. I just think she could do better, but I don't know. It is what it is. There's probably other things behind the scenes that about that situation, which I really can't talk about. But yeah, El Generico was the man in this match. I thought the match started off really slow. Mike Bennett was very goofy in this match, kind of laughable, kind of, some of his tactics kind of made this match seem very I would say very unappealing. But Generico was the man here. Generico busted his ass. Jay Lethal looked pretty good as well. There were some really nice exchanges with Lethal and Generico. But Bennett played a heel pretty nicely in this match. He really picked his spots. He wrestled a smart match. He really didn't do a lot, but he did just enough to pull out the victory, and he did win the television champ. Oh no, he lost. He lost the match. He didn't win it. He actually rolled up El Generico. God, why am I thinking Bennett won the TV title? Everyone was assuming he was going to win. He didn't win. Jay Lethal actually did retain. Jesus. I don't know what I'm thinking. Yeah, so yeah, Lethal retained, but Bennett did get the pinfall on Generico, though. A pretty sweet finish right there. Like probably like a 3.5-star match. Really sweet stuff. But the last like 5 minutes were really awesome. Yeah, but it got off to a really slow start. All right, next up, you had Kevin Steen versus Steve Corino. Now this feud really didn't call for all these hardcore spots. I would say there really wasn't enough heat to make this. Kind of buy into everything that they did, but it was pretty awesome though. I mean, it's Steen definitely brings it in the ring. He always delivers, and he's per both these guys are perfect for this setting. Steve Corino bleached his hair back to the old school ECW, blonde, bleach blonde hair that he used to have. That was pretty cool. And I mean, Corino and Steen did some really vicious things out there. They took apart the steel guardrail, which is heavy and hard as hell, and Steen got tossed right onto that. It looked like it broke his back. I mean, you can't be doing that shit every, maybe once a year. Steen could be doing this type of stuff, but yeah, it's definitely going to cut his career short. There was actually a table set up with like a couple chairs on top of it, and Steen actually got backdropped on it. I think Carino took a cradle pile driver on a set of a couple chairs, which was really, really sick. I mean, these two guys they busted their ass. This is the match of the night. Definitely, Jimmy Jacobs refereeing. Jacobs was great throughout this whole thing. He kind of kept the fans on the edge of the seat about whether he was going to screw Carino over, which really wouldn't have made him a heel or anything like that. So that was pretty unnecessary. But yeah, it was pretty cool. So Steen is back in Ring of Honor. He won the match, and that's thank God, because Kevin Steen's been missing. I think it was kind of. People are going to be saying that they did a beautiful job of building this up. They really have. They've been really patient with the whole Steen thing. But at the same time, not having Steen within the company last year definitely hurt a lot of the shows and hurt the overall feel of the company. It really did. So thank God Kevin Steen is back. I would definitely say Steen was the MVP of the show in the ring and on the mic and just the total package tonight. I got to give credit to Kevin Steen. He was the man tonight. All right, so after intermission, we had the tag team turmoil. This was kind of disappointing. Cedric Alexander, Caprice Coleman looked okay here. I wouldn't say they looked great, but it's really, really tough to be a Ring of Honor wrestler. It's very stressful, I would imagine. There's tons of criticism. You're expected to deliver in the ring on a consistent basis, but I say you got to give guys at least 6 months to get warmed up. We'll see what they could do. It was kind of tough for Cedric and Caprice Coleman to really, to really get any momentum out of this match, I would say. But yeah, Coleman O'Reilly looked really good. Kyle O'Reilly was great here. He really busted his ass. He did the rolling butterfly suplex thing. He did it like five or six times in a row. He almost got a standing ovation. Young Bucks were a little bit more heelish than they typically are, I would say. They did look great. A problem with this match is All Night Express were the last team to come out. I think Red Titus actually was selling injury the whole match. He legitimately is hurt right now, so this couldn't be as good as it was. We kind of got a different finish with the referee stopping the match because Rhett couldn't really, he was in so much pain that they had to stop the match, and the Young Bucks really went after his knee. So yeah, it looks like we'll get a Young Bucks in the All Night Express program coming up. But overall, the tag team turmoil thing, I just expect a lot more from it. I only give it like 3 stars. All right, after that, you had Roderick Strong's Invitational. It was that Young Knockout kid, Chris Hero, making his return. A lot of controversy with Chris Hero right now. Thank God it wasn't Homicide. It wasn't Nigel, but it was Chris Hero, which I was happy about. Hero coming out got a great pop, great reaction with the Kings of Wrestling theme. But I would say that this was poorly booked. I don't think this needed to be about 20 minutes. It just went way too long. The crowd was kind of dead after a couple minutes. I think the problem with Roderick and Chris Hero is Roderick was trying to control the match. Sometimes when Roderick is a heel and controlling a lot of the offense, it's very, very dull. I think it worked better in 2008 when Hero was the aggressor. I think Hero plays a better heel in the actual match and dictating the tempo and have Roderick make his, babyface comeback. I think it just works better like that. This had a pretty cool finish, though. Truth Martini got involved and Roderick ended up getting the win. But pretty stiff. Hero looked, I would say, a little flabby here. There's rumors that he had high levels of testosterone. There was you take steroids chance. And Hero, he definitely looks like he hasn't been working out, or he's just not, maybe he's just not taking whatever medication or supplements that he was taking while he was within the Kings of Wrestling. It's just, he just didn't look healthy out there. I don't know. It's just kind of confusing to me. But I hope Hero stays. I would like to see Hero back on the roster. I hope they can use him. if the WWE doesn't have a place for him. That's pretty much all I could say. But Roderick and Hero was kind of disappointing. I only give it about maybe 3 stars. Next up, you had the World's Greatest Tag Team taking on the Briscoes. You know, World's Greatest Tag Team, Haas and Benjamin, got a lot of heat without even trying to turn heel at first. But before the match started, they clocked the Briscoes with the championships, and they, you know, Haas was saying fuck you to the fans. He was saying, I don't give a fuck what you motherfuckers think, sticking their middle fingers up. So they pretty much went full-fledged heel, and the Briscoes were pretty much, you know, treated like the baby faces, which I didn't agree with from a booking standpoint. I think you could have got so much more out of this match if you just let the fans naturally, you know, decide who to cheer for. I think, you know, Haas and Benjamin would have got even more heat. This was kind of like, it was more of a brawl, actually. You know, the match didn't really officially get underway until, you know, a few minutes. And I just think it could have been better if you had, you know, more hot tags. And if this was just more of a regular, you know, old school wrestling tag match, I just think it would have came off much better. And the Briscoes did win the belts back, which I'm happy about. But I don't know. I really feel like Haas and Benjamin just need to go. They were sucking on purpose. You know, Benjamin, I don't know, I think Benjamin might have botched that leap spot on purpose. I really think he might have done it just to get heat. So, yeah, overall disappointing. You know, Briscoes and Haas and Benjamin, you know, it just didn't deliver. I thought this was probably the worst match of the night. I just couldn't get into it. I was just really disgusted throughout the whole match. Haas needs to go. Maybe Benjamin needs to go, too, because he looked like shit as well. So, it was what it was, man. Next up, main event, you had Eddie Edwards versus Davey Richards for the Ring of Honor World Championship. I don't know, I'll just say this. I don't mind incorporating MMA into professional wrestling matches. But if you're going to do these MMA storylines, I just don't think they work. I think it's better just to keep that stuff out. I'm not a really big MMA fan. You know, I don't really talk about it. I'd much rather prefer to watch boxing over MMA, but I respect mixed martial arts. I love it. I mean, I love the opportunity that it gives guys like a Brock Lesnar and guys like that. But, you know, I just don't think pro wrestling and MMA should be really mixed within storylines. If you want to use some MMA holds and moves and, you know, incorporate that into the match, I'm fine with that. But I don't know. The storyline felt really stale and sucky to me. I don't think it really did anything. You know, the crowd was dead. You know, Davey had to really fight hard to get the crowd into it. I still say it was a 4-star match, though. You know, if some of you guys, you know, were disappointed with their match from Best in the World or didn't really like it, you're probably not going to like this that much. Did tell a pretty good story, though, with, you know, Davey trying to just murder Eddie. He actually did a couple of dragon suplexes, you know, off the top rope, off the side of the ring apron. He actually did another dragon suplex to him, and Eddie landed on the mat on the floor. So Eddie took a lot of questionable bumps. He really took a lot of vicious bumps in this match. But the intensity was still there. They slapped the taste of each other's mouths, just a lot of slaps to the face, legit. A lot of stiff kicks from Davey, a lot of intensity. But the crowd just wasn't there. There was actually a "This match sucks" chant, which wasn't very loud, you know. But at the same time, it's just really, I don't know, the second half was really reminiscent of, you know, Final Battle 2009, which was pretty mediocre, I would say. So, I don't know, I'll still give it a 4-star rating, Davey and Eddie, but I don't know, it just, you know, Davey Rich is really stale right now, and on top of that, you got Roderick making fun of him, and Kevin Steen, you know, coming out and saying, oh, go back and jerk off with your, you know, MMA buddies. It just, you know, I don't know. Is that what you really want to do to your baby face? You know, turn the fans against them? Which is what they pretty much did tonight. So, I don't know. You know, Davey's really lost some of that hardcore edge that he had a couple years ago. So, we'll see if he can get it back. And Kevin Steen came out. Great promo there. We're going to build towards Davey and Steen coming up. So, it was what it was. Overall, I'd say, you know, try to check out the show. It was hit or miss. You know, I would say it was a poorly booked show. I think it could have been much better if you know, cleaned up a couple stuff from the second half. But it is what it is, man. Ring of Honor is really stale right now. This was definitely the worst year in Ring of Honor history. That's just my opinion. I believe the WWE was a better promotion this year, no matter what anyone says. That's just my opinion. If you don't agree, that's fine. I'd rather have someone disagree with me then agree with me sometimes. You know, I like different opinions. So it is what it is. Final Battle 2011, I would say it was average.